rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm your host for today, Hamza Turki. And let me welcome all of you to today's graduation day. On behalf of the Talhah ibn Ubayd-Allah team and the entire Giraas team, alhamdulillah, today's event is packed with loads of fun filled and educational and amazing performance by our team. So let's dive straight in. So, who exactly was Talhah ibn Ubayd-Allah radiallahu anhu? Let us learn about this great companion who described as a martyr walking on earth. He is one of the 10, the Ashratul Mubashireen, the 10 who are promised paradise in the world itself. Subhanallah, isn't that amazing? We pray to Allah Azza wa Jal to grant us all Jannah. Ameen. In the day of Uhud, did you know that Talhah radiallahu anhu displayed his bravery? And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu described the day of Uhud as the day of Talhah. MashaAllah, what an honor. And it was that day that the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, named him as Talhah al-Khayr. Allahu Akbar. He was a very brave, courageous, and a very devoted Muslim. May Allah Azza wa Jal grant us such bravery and righteousness. Ameen. Okay, now let us meet our future da'is and da'is. First, we have Maria Liaquat Khan. She is currently living in Jeddah and she adores swimming, painting and even cycling. She's very disciplined and very caring too. Then, Ammar Sadiq Usman. He lives in Nigeria and he loves coding and playing PlayStation 4. Is smart and kind. Then we have Simra Fazil Azmi, who lives in Hyderabad in India. She likes reading books and she's very shy and sweet. And then we have Hilal Abdullah, who lives in Sri Lanka and he loves playing football and reading the Quran. MashaAllah, subhanAllah. He's very helpful and lovely. Then we have Fatima Zuhar, who lives in Sri Lanka too, and she loves doing journal writing and calligraphy. She's very smart and very caring too. Then up we have Adnan Asif Riaz, who lives currently in Chennai, India, and he likes reading and even likes solving jigsaw puzzles and even cycling, and he's very talkative and fun-loving. And then Alina Mushahid, who lives in Oman, and she likes painting and creativity. And she's very kind-hearted and lovable. Then we have Faraj Nalim, who lives in Sri Lanka too, and he loves reading and playing football like me. And he's very sweet and funny too. And then up we have Khadija Kausar, who lives in India, Bangalore. She loves painting and craft. She's very shy and innocent. Next up, it's me. I live in Chennai, India. I love reading and playing football, and I'm very enthusiastic and a sporty person. And next up, we have my friend Ayhan Bashir, who lives in Kerala, India. He loves playing football and reading books. He's very kind and very curious too. Then we have Amal Riaz BK, who lives in Bahrain. He likes doing art and crafts and even likes making YouTube videos and loves playing Xbox. He's very creative and confident. And the last but not the least is Isa Rakshin, who lives in Sri Lanka and he loves reading Quran, subhanAllah, and drawing and painting. He's very kind and very brave. Next, let us hear, listen to the beautiful recitation of the mighty Quran by Ammar.
Allahu Rajeem. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل قيما لينذر بأسا شديدا من لدنه ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا ماكثين فيه أبدا وينذر الذين قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا ما لهم به من علم ولا لآبائهم كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم إن يقولون إلا كذبا فلعلك باقٍ نفسك على آثارهم إن لم يؤمنون بهذا الحديث أسفا إنا جعلنا ما على الأرض زينة لنبلوهم وأيها أحسن عملا وإنا لجاعلون ما عليها صعيدا جرزا أم حسبت أن أصحاب الكهف والرقيم من كانوا من آياتنا عجبا إذ أوى الفتنة إلى الكهف فقالوا ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا
MashaAllah, what a beautiful recitation by Ammar. Now let's hear a translation by Isa.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious and the most merciful. All praise is for Allah who has revealed the book to his servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, allowing no wickedness in it, making it perfectly upright to warn the disbelievers of a severe torment from him. To give good news to the believers who do good, that they will have a fine reward, in which they will remain forever. And to warn those who claim Allah has offspring. They have no knowledge of this, nor did their forefathers. Of the terrible claim that comes out of their mouths. They know nothing but lies. Now, perhaps you, O Prophet, will grieve yourself to death over their denial if they continue to disbelieve in this message. We have indeed made whatever is on earth as an adornment for it, in order to test which of them is best indeed. And we will certainly reduce whatever is on it to barren ground. How you, O Prophet, thought that the people of the cave and the plague were the only wonders of our times? Remember, when those youths took refuge in the cave and said, Our Lord, grant us mercy from yourselves and guide us rightly to our ordeal.
Subhanallah. Now, Subhanallah. Next, we have a nasheed by Maria.
Three elements of Iman. Iman is the faith, belief in the heart. Iman is the speech upon the tongue. Iman is the action of the limbs. It increases with obedience and decreases by sinning. Iman is the faith, belief in the heart. Iman is the speech upon the tongue. Iman is the action of the limbs, increases with obedience and decreases by sinning. These are the three elements of Iman. These are the three elements of Iman. Belief in the heart, speech upon the tongue, actions of the limbs are the elements of Iman. Believe in the heart, speech upon the tongue, actions of the limbs are the elements of Iman.
Next up, we have another nasheed by Fatima.
Mad is a very sad, just like this. If you see a Hamza after it, we have to prolong into four harakat, four harakat, four harakat. Mad is a very sad, just like this. If any other letter comes after it, we have to prolong into six harakat, six harakat, six harakat. Let me tell you a secret my teacher told me. After the mad sana shada it will be. If there's no hamza coming after mad, six harakat it will be. If there is no hamza coming after mad, six harakat it will be.
MashaAllah, so beautiful. Next, we have another nasheed by me. Next, we have Faraj, Angels and Their Beauty. Faraj.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Who are angels? Angels are beings created from light. They obey Allah's every command. There are two angels in our shoulders. They write good and bad deeds. One angel guards the gates of heaven, and the other guards the gates of hell. Angel Jibreel alayhi salam was the angel who revealed Wahi to the prophets. There is an angel who controls the rain as Allah's wish. Malak al-Maut is the angel of death. There are other angels, but these are the ones we know about. Zakallah khair.
Subhanallah. Next, we have the names of Allah by Adnan Asif.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. These are the 99 names of Allah. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Malik, Al-Quddus, Al-Salam, Al-Mu'min, Al-Muhaymin, Al-Aziz, Al-Jabbar, Al-Mutakabbir, Al-Khaliq, Al-Bari, Al-Musawwir, Al-Ghaffar, Al-Qahhar, Al-Wahhab, Al-Razzaq, Al-Fattah, Al-Alim, Al-Qabid, Al-Basit, Al-Khafid, Al-Rafi', Al-Mu'iz, Al-Muzil, Al-Sami', Al-Basir, Al-Hakim, Al-Adl, Al-Latif, Al-Khabir, Al-Halim, Al-Azim, Al-Ghafur, Al-Shakur, العلي الكبير الحفيظ المطيب الحسيب الجليل الكريم الرقيب المجيب الواسع الحكيم الودود المجيد الباعث الشهيد الحق الوكيل القوي المتين الولي الحميد المحسي المبدي المعيد المحيي المميت الحي القيوم الواجد الماجد الواحد الأحد الصمد القدير المقتدر المقدم المؤخر الأول الآخر الظاهر الباطن الوالي المتعالي البر التواب المنتقم العفو الرؤوف مالك الملك ذو الجلال والإكرام المقصد الجامع الغني المغني المانع الذر النافع النور الحادي البادع الباقع الوارث الرشيد السابور. جزاك الله خير.
ما شاء الله. Next we have the مخرج والحروف by سمرة.
This is the train of articulation points of makharij. First one is al-jab. Three letters of mad. Alif, ya, and waw. Second department is all of al-halq. Throat letters.
Next, we have our teacher Shifa. So every Saturday we had Tarbiya class with teacher Shifa Noor in the main room. We always had a blast. Never a dull moment with her and her engaging presentations. Every Saturday and Sunday were days of celebration. Games and activities just added to the fun. Winning the Kahoot was always goal number one. Next, we entered our breakout room. The teacher is not as in charge with her. The Talhah ibn Ubayd-Allah always got to charge. She was friendly, kind, and patient. We learned so much in energy segment. But no Giraas program is complete without Ustaz Zahra. Her contribution is immense and key to the Giraas success. It's all what we're so grateful for. We can't even find words to express. Alhamdulillah. Jazakallah khairan. Next, we have in the ending, we have a surah, a chapter number Noor, verse number 36 by Hilal Abdullah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. الله نور السماوات والأرض. مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح. المصباح في زجاجة. الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة. مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار نور على نور يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله بكل شيء عليم.
ما شاء الله. What a beautiful class by Hilal. Barakallah feek to everyone. What a fun time we have had today. Everyone was truly amazing and such a joy to watch. Subhanallah. The Talhah ibn Ubaydullah's team performances were truly remarkable. Jazakumullah khairan to Ustaz Zahra, Ustaz Shifa, and teacher Isna, and the entire Giraas team for a wonderful time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakumullah khairan, and see you all in the graduation of the next batch.